Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab Frequency Planning Part 1. In this video, we'll discuss clock generator basics, frequency calculation, and how to generate two output frequencies from a single PLL. Clock generators are commonly used to generate multiple frequency outputs with various driver formats. You can find clock generators, jitter cleaners, or network synchronizers in almost every system, often replacing multiple oscillators to reduce system BOM and total solution size. Let's start by introducing the basic structure of a clock generator. A clock generator produces multiple frequency outputs from a single reference input through one or more phase lock loops. The reference input to a clock generator can be a crystal, an oscillator, or a clock output from a previous stage in the clock tree. A phase lock loop, or PLL, is a feedback system where the voltage-controlled oscillator, or VCO, tracks the phase and frequency of the reference input. As a result, the VCO output frequency is the phase detector frequency multiplied n times. For more details on PLL basics and theories, visit Phase Lock Loop Fundamentals training series. Each output divider, notated here with a D letter, in a clock generator can select one of the PLLs, divide it down, and generate an output frequency. Sometimes multiple outputs are grouped together and share a common output divider. In that case, those outputs always have the same frequency. Now that we are familiar with clock generator building blocks, think about this system use case. How would we generate 156.25 MHz, a common Ethernet frequency, from an input reference of 25 MHz? According to the datasheet, the VCO frequency range of this clock generator is from 4.8 GHz to 5.4 GHz. With an integer output divider, what division values can generate 156.25 MHz from the given VCO range? If you would like a second to think about the input-output frequency relationship, pause the video. The lower limit of the divider value is the minimum VCO frequency divided by output frequency. Or in this case, 4.8 GHz divided by 156.25 MHz, which is equal to 30.72. Similarly, the upper limit is 5.4 GHz divided by 156.25 MHz, which is equal to 34.56. The value D must be an integer, in this case, between the two values that we see. Therefore, the available divider values are 31, 32, 33, and 34. For this example, we use D equal to 32. Therefore, the VCO frequency is equal to 5 GHz. Now let's go back to the input. In order to optimize our output phase noise, we want to set the phase detector frequency to the highest possible value. Therefore, set R equal to 1 and reference frequency into the phase detector becomes 25 MHz. The end divider is simply 5 GHz divided by 25 MHz, which is 200 in this case. The value for the end divider is simply 5 GHz divided by 25 MHz, which gives us 200. We've worked out the values of the R divider, end divider, and the output divider. The PLL is now locked, and the output frequency is the desired 156.25 MHz. In the previous example, we used an output divider equal to 32. What if we use an output divider value equal to 33 instead? The required VCO frequency is still within the min and max frequencies of the VCO and now becomes 5156.25 MHz. But n is no longer an integer value. Instead, n becomes a fractional number of 206.25, and the PLL now operates in a fractional mode. The fractional n divider consists of three parts, an integer n divider, a numerator, and a denominator. The fractional divider value is simply n plus the numerator over the denominator. In this case, n is equal to 206, the numerator is 1, and the denominator is 4. Generally, we would prefer to set a PLL to integer mode instead of fractional mode, because fractional mode introduces the possibility of fractional noise and spurs, which will degrade the output jitter performance. However, this can come at a price. When an integer divide value requires a very low phase detector frequency, this brings up the phase noise. There are many ways to slice an onion, and one could also, for example, change the 25 MHz reference oscillator to 25.03034 MHz. In most cases, sticking with a standard frequency such as 25 MHz is preferred due to component availability and cost. Now that we know how to generate a single output frequency, let's look at generating two output frequencies from one PLL at the same time. In this case, the input is still 25 MHz, and the VCO range is, as before, 4.8 to 5.4 GHz. How would we configure the dividers D0 and D1 to generate both 100 MHz and 156.25 MHz from a common VCO frequency? Pause the video if you want a second to think about this question. In order to generate two frequencies from one PLL, the VCO frequency needs to be the common multiple of both outputs. If we list the common multiples of 100 MHz and 156.25 MHz, only 5 GHz falls within the VCO frequency range. Therefore, VCO frequency is 5 GHz, output divider D0 is 50, output divider D1 is 32, and the end divider is 200. But what can we do if no common multiple falls within the VCO range? A typical application is to generate 32.768 kHz and 48 MHz at the same time with a 24 MHz reference frequency input. With a VCO range of 2.4 to 2.8 GHz, no common multiple of the two outputs is available. What options do we have? Previously, we've been discussing frequency calculation with zero frequency error. However, sometimes it's okay to have a small amount of frequency error defined as ppm, or parts per million, frequency offset. For this example, we will introduce another constraint with a prescalar divider after the VCO, meaning that the output divider must be divisible by 4, 5, or 6. One way to approach this would be listing all possible output divider values for 48 MHz, then deciding which VCO frequency can generate 32.768 kHz with minimum frequency error. Pause the video if you want to try this for yourself. One possible solution is VCO frequency of 2.4 GHz, output divider D0 set to 50, output divider D1 set to 73,242. Output 0 has no frequency error, and output 1 has a 2.56 ppm frequency error. For more discussion on frequency planning and how to minimize spurs and crosstalk, look for our next training module, Frequency Planning Part 2. To find more technical information and to search products, visit ti.com/clocks. Please try our short 4-question quiz to check your understanding of this video's content. True or false? The relationship between FVCO, or the VCO frequency, D, the output divider value, and fout, the output frequency, is fout is equal to fvco times d. False. Choose one. The relationship between phase detector frequency, end divider value, numerator of fractional divider, denominator of fractional divider, and the VCO frequency for a fractional PLL is... True or false? There is only one combination of reference input frequency, phase detector frequency, and divider values that can generate the desired output frequency, fout. Choose all that apply. Which constraints determine the relationship between VCO frequency, frequency of output 1, frequency of output 2, minimum VCO frequency, and maximum VCO frequency for generating 0 ppm outputs?